According to court documents we've obtained, prosecutors paint a picture of three greedy town councilors looking to cash in on their votes. In one instance, an alleged solicitation for a bribe was actually sent via text message. In an 80-page indictment unsealed today, the federal probe into alleged bribery and extortion by three former North Providence town councilors expanded. Indicted today by a federal grand jury, North Providence attorney Robert Cerisi, a former town solicitor seen here in file video, and developer Edward Amundi of North Providence. Both men are charged with acting as middlemen in four separate bribery schemes. Court documents reveal the schemes added up to more than $100,000 to be paid to three town council members, but prosecutors say both Cerisi and Amundi got a cut of the deal. This case first burst on the scene on May 27th, charged with selling their votes for cash. Former town council president Joseph Birchfield, former councilman John Zamborano, and former councilman Raymond Douglas. They each face additional charges from today's indictment. One charge alleges Birchfield and Douglas tried to extort $3,000 from a business owner in exchange for a liquor license. Prosecutors say the men used the code phrase ham sandwich to refer to the cash. Court documents show a middleman sent this text message to the owner. If you do the right thing, you will get a liquor license. The owner says, "Are you expletive nuts? Nobody is getting anything for that license. This is real life. This isn't a movie like The Sopranos where you have to pay for things." The middleman says just passing along a message. Investigators say the business owner refused to pay up. Now new details that the men allegedly tried again, this time asking for $75,000 from another developer to allow a renovation in this mill complex in North Providence. When the deal looked like it was falling apart, investigators recorded this phone conversation between Douglas and Zamborano. Douglas says, "I was thinking maybe we were too greedy or something. Should have just asked for a little bit." Zamborano, "What did you say to him?" Douglas, "Maybe we should have said 50, you know what I mean, and not been a pig." Court documents show the three men allegedly received an initial payment of $21,000 for the project, and Monday is charged with coordinating the extortion on the mill project in the parking lot of the Cadillac Lounge Strip Club. A hearing on this case is expected early next week. Now, attorney Mark Dana, he represents Joseph Birchfield. He tells me that they're just going through the indictment now. But as with the other charges, they want to know who the government's sources are and how reliable they are. Live with the Target 12 investigators, Tim White, Eyewitness News.